This bird is the definition of you are what you eat.
I can feel their feathers. They're so close to me.
They spend so much time at the crustacean buffet that they've turned the color of their favorite meal.
Oh, say hello to the scarlet ibises of Bird Kingdom.
This is the scarlet ibis.
Aranya, and you're watching Animalogic's World of Birds. Today, we're in Bird Kingdom in Niagara Falls, feeding the lorikeets.
And when they've got their fill, I'm going to meet a bird that's seriously pretty in pink. In the wild, ibises have to be in constant lookout for predators, but we have an even greater threat, identity theft. Recently, my credit card got hacked and I didn't have access to my account for a few days. And that's why I'm excited to share today's sponsor, Aura. Aura is identity theft protection, fraud monitoring, a VPN, password management, and antivirus software all combined into one easy-to-use app. Aura monitors the dark web for your emails, passwords, and social security numbers, and sends alerts fast, right to your phone and email. It also gives you near real-time alerts on suspicious credit inquiries, like if someone was opening a loan or credit card in your name. Protect your family and yourself from identity theft at www.aura.com/animallogic. And if you sign up right now, Aura will give you a 2-week free trial with my link so you can see for yourself how many times Aura finds you or your family member's personal info on the dark web. Thanks, Aura.
Hello, we have arrived at Bird Kingdom, and we're entering the small bird aviary. It really feels like we're walking through a rainforest.
Hi everybody, just a normal Tuesday afternoon, hanging out with the scarlet ibises.
The scarlet ibis is one of two living species in the genus Eudocimus.
These ibises are related to the American white ibis.
But obviously, they're a little more interesting than their plain white North American counterparts. They belong to the wading bird family Thrascyornithidae, which includes ibises from around the world, as well as one of my favorite birds, the roseate spoonbill. The ibis family is full of colorful characters. But only the scarlet ibis can boast a pink plumage. Or is it red? Or orange? Let's just keep it simple and go with scarlet, like their name. Whatever shade of pink they are, they're all gorgeous, so I'll have to pop back in the studio with an outfit to match.
As long as on Wednesdays they wear pink, they can sit with us. Or stand gracefully, I guess.
Scarlet ibises live in wet, marshy habitats in South America and the Caribbean.
Even though they love spending time in the water, scarlet ibises are actually pretty great flyers.
They migrate long distances in the classic V formation. They'll glide and soar through the sky at high heights and fast speeds. But for shorter distances, they fly in what scientists call, damn, that's a lot of birds. Unlike the world's most iconic pink bird, the flamingo, scarlet ibises are quite small.
They're so tiny. They're much tinier than I thought they would be.
They're just about 60 centimeters tall and only weigh a little over 1 kilogram. They have long pink legs and a long curved bill, which they use to look for food in soft mud or under plants.
Despite being waders, scarlet ibises don't have super webbed feet. This allows them to perch in trees and move through mud easily. And now, for the moment you've been waiting for. Why? They're pink! And the very shocking answer is, their diet. So, the same as flamingos.
I was really hoping for a more exciting reason, like they evolved specifically to blend in with Regina George's bedroom. But alas. The scarlet ibis primarily eats insects, shrimp, crabs, mollusks, and other crustaceans. And those shrimp and red shellfish contain a red pigment called astaxanthin.
And eventually that pigmentation carries over to these ibises.
Eat enough crabs and suddenly you start to look like a crab. Just not the whole claw part. Some researchers believe that the American white ibis and the scarlet ibis are actually the same species, and it's just their difference in diet that sets them apart. We're still not sure why more scientists haven't fed white ibises a scarlet ibis's diet to see what happens. What are you waiting for, science? We don't recommend force-feeding yourself shrimp to see if it would work for you, though. Like the flamingo, scarlet ibises are super social serial monogamists. They're huge believers of safety in numbers, as it makes predator attacks less likely and dilutes the danger of being attacked for each individual. They'll even hang out with spoonbills, herons, and ducks to have more eyes on the sky. Everyone's welcome. Well, I mean, except for the predators, of course. They live in flocks of 30 or more, and mating pairs arrange their nests close to other couples in the same tree.
Scarlet ibis nests have been called artless, because really, it's just a loose formation of sticks. But we can be kinder and call them minimalist.
When it's time to breed, the male will perform mating moves like preening, shaking, head rubbing, and showing off just how high he can fly. Come on, man. Play it cool.
You can tell the males apart from the females because males have slightly larger beaks.
5 days after a very romantic cloacal kiss, mom will lay 3 to 5 eggs.
Juvenile scarlet ibises are usually dusty brown and white. It's only through feeding that they get their bright magenta color.
So eat up, little scarlet ibis, and maybe one day you'll grow up to be as scarlet as mom and dad.
So what should we talk about next? Let me know in the comments down below, and don't forget to subscribe for new episodes every week. Thanks for watching. See you later. These are the accessories I've always wanted in my life.